We begin tonight with an exclusive interview with Salinas Mayor Dennis Donohue as he opens up about his decision to not seek re-election. During his past 6 years in office, there have been ups and downs, including a violent day in 2009 with three separate shootings. But also, there's been praise for bringing passion and dedication to a part-time job that he treats more like a full-time responsibility. Action News reporter Tom Miller spoke with the mayor about his service. He joins us live from our Salinas newsroom. Tom?
Well, Brittany, in our interview, we talk with the mayor about his struggle to turn his vision for the city into a reality, and also what he calls one of his toughest days as mayor, a day that actually ended here in the KSBW newsroom. But first, we start with why he's stepping down after 6 years that he calls pretty successful.
We met the mayor in front of his house in Salinas on the heels of his unexpected announcement Friday.
I am honored to have served this great city. This will be my last state of the city.
But why now?
There's a real balancing act in terms of city, work, family, health, and I felt I could probably go pretty hard at it for 6 years, and I gave some thought to looking at another term, but it just became very, very clear to me that that balance wasn't going to hold.
He works as mayor 40 to 50 hours a week, endless events, constant meetings, a paycheck of $800 a month.
Last Saturday, I think I made five stops, five appearances, and that's not atypical.
Did it affect your health, this job?
I take two more pills than when I became the mayor, so maybe it did. I don't know. I mean, I still feel pretty energetic, but I take more pills.
January 15, 2009 was likely the most stressful day. Six people were shot in three separate shootings.
What started at 6 o'clock with me being informed, as I recall the sequence, shooting one, shooting two, shooting three, that was a tough day.
And people were hungry for answers. He spoke live that night with Dan Green and Aaron Clark as they pressed him for a solution.
We don't have a serious habitual offender program. We're not using gang injunctions. We're not using safety zone injunctions.
That's
we're
speculative.
Not using
Dan,
fully proactive.
Dan, you're speculating. Dan, you are speculating on what is or isn't being done.
Well,
if you want a very thorough discussion and you've got the time to have it, we'll have it. So I'm ready if you are.
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, let's.
Do we have gang injunctions in place?
You would have to ask the DA.
I look back on that, and it was a tough year. And that was probably the moment that really began to define that year of, okay, it's going to be a rough ride. But I think out of that came a lot of really, really positive things.
They developed a three-pronged strategy focusing on enforcement, prevention, and intervention. However, in his opinion, the resources to implement them aren't there.
We would really make significant progress within 10 years, in my view, if we had everything lined up. We're doing a terrific job with the resources we have, but the trick is, can we sustain that momentum?
There is progress. Shootings were at a 9-year low last year with 49 in Salinas. But just as the numbers are starting to improve, he's leaving.
It was a difficult decision, but it's basically what I had hoped for in the beginning. And as I say, just that balancing act wasn't going to hold. And ultimately, if that doesn't hold, I wouldn't be able to do the right job for the city.
And I asked him if he's stepping down in an effort to seek some higher political office. He didn't rule it out, but he also didn't really want to talk about that. He says right now he's focused on his specialty vegetable business and his family, like he said in the interview. Brittany.
All right, Tom, thank you so much. Now, Mayor Donohue also says the gang problem in Salinas is tied directly to the city's economic and business climate. And if the city can generate more tax revenue, then it'll be able to better afford the costs associated with fighting gang violence.